Hey there, folks, welcome to Redshirt Plays Moss on PlayStation VR Part 1. Hope you have a good day, and if you do, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and turn on those notifications. And as always, I stream every Wednesday and every other Saturday on youtube.com/redshirtsgaming. Hope to see you there.
Volume up a bit. Okay, what's like?
Your time has come at last, dear reader.
Nice.
While we began this tale long ago, we hope it is yours to finish. But this story is not yours alone. It is tied to another. And the journey you take together could change the fate of both our worlds. Shall we begin?
Sure. Right, there we go. Clean up my glass here. Shall begin.
They called it the Cinder Knight. What came from those dark, starless skies would change the world of Moss forever. The peace that had settled across the land was broken by an unconquerable nightmare.
Okay.
And that night, the animals nearly met their end.
Oh, little flakes of dust in the air. I love it. Yeah. Next page.
Killed the king. A winged creature broke from the shadows and plucked him from his royal bedchamber high atop the tallest tower. Next,
witty.
Serpent Sarfog and the armies of the arcane tore off from the underworld. They ravaged the castle in search of that which gave the king power beyond understanding, one of the fabled glass relics. King's guard fought bravely, but the castle soon pulsed with the arcane's evil. Every room was gutted, every statue, tapestry.
Dirty again, really?
But the glass was never found. Even the reclusive sprites set aside their differences on that fated night.
Okay.
They sent a great champion, empowered by their own glass relic, to challenge the serpent and its steel army.
Army. Right?
Meanwhile, Sir Argus, commander of the King's Guard, led the survivors west through a temple long abandoned by their ancestors and far away from their newly risen enemies.
So they ran.
It was an arduous escape. Finally, after passage beneath the impassable mire, they found refuge in a clearing hidden safely in the trees. Argus charged back to join the sprite champion at the mire's edge. Together, they fought back the arcane and sealed the temple passage
Something
that led to the clearing.
Little.
But the champion was gravely injured. Clutching his glass, he retreated deep into the forest where he drew his last breath. A large tree grew upon him. It stood many years in watchful duty, safeguarding the glass and awaiting its next hero.
Swoosh. Hey.
That hero, albeit an unlikely one, did arrive at a time she'd be needed most.
Hello. Interesting. I like this view. What water? Oh, look at that, look at that. That's moving. There you go.
Was out adventuring beyond the edge of the clearing.
That looks amazing.
Dusk was creeping in, but she wondered what she might find if she went just a little farther.
Do anything? Let's see. Ooh.
My
Jesus. Circling back. What did you find? Really awesome that you can just look at every little detail in the area if you want. Ooh, shard. Shard. It's amazing. Oh, hello.
She was not exactly
You're seeing
sure
me.
What she roused, but she felt no danger from the being silently peering.
Oh, hello.
At
her. Hey.
Hi there.
Quill had to hurry. The village gates would soon close, and night would follow.
Oh, I can grab the shard, I guess. Oh, I can control Quill now. Let's go. Hey. Slice and dice. Pretty awesome, actually.
Bye, Quill.
What? Ooh. So grab your backpack, apparently. Ooh. Wait. Ooh. Hello. Oh, I get it now. Let's climb up. Awesome.
Hello.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Wait. This is starting to get more interesting. Oh, can't move there, right? Yeah, all right. There, I guess. Up. You want to go up, huh? Okay, now go back. Oh no, I see. I see.
Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present. But Quill preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest.
Assassin's Creed this. You. Down you go. Wait, I get it, I get it, I get it. Back. Nice, 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 nice. What's that? I got a trophy, but I don't know what. I'll check that out after, yeah, recording. Quill. Oh, the gates are closing. Oh, there you are. Over there too. I was, but I got some. Go over, all right. Oh, little Quill, go! Hack-a-doodle. Yeah, there we go. Downwards. I love this. This would be awesome for D&D. Oh. Flash. Flash. I like. Yeah, I can pull them out, but also. Like, thing. Oh, there's no way for me to get up there? E. Almost. Here we go. Extra up there. Another scroll, whatever that is. Here, oh, well, guess that was it. I could have rung the bell.
Hi.
This is amazing to look at, though. And another trophy, apparently.
Hi, hi.
Go inside. Oh, get up. Okay. Hey, little mice. Oh, this one's fishing. Nice. Can I? No, I cannot interfere. Again, I'm gonna have to put this down for a sec. Again, I smudged the left lens. I think it's too close to my face. So, let's see, a little bit less close. Let's see how it works out. Oh, hello. There you are. I'm gonna go over. I can stop that, okay, but this I cannot do anything with. Hey. Guess I'll have to go through here. Or not. Oh no no no, wait, 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 wait. Let's see here, slowing it down. Thingy there. Over there. Scroll, that's what I was looking for. There we go. Climb, little quill, climb. Nope. Too late. One, two, the passage. Yeah, yeah, I know you need to go up. There we go, better. Be more careful when jumping. Hang on. Up you go. To the scroll. Right, scroll number three. Go back up here, I don't know what's up there, but... That's the best way, I guess, to the other side. Uh-huh. There we go, the easy way. And... Come on. There you go. Perfect.
Bill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass.
There we go, little quill. A squirrel?
She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend.
Alright, we'll see that.
Uncle Little Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Hmm?
Uncle, Uncle, there's something you have to see. Out past the bell again,
mm-hmm.
scolded. Quill, I've told you countless mm-hmm. times. I know, Quill replied, crestfallen.
Right.
I didn't mean to worry you, but I found Ooh. Something strange and magical.
Eight and 12 then. 12 pieces. 12 chapters.
Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass. What is it? She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Okay.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Mm-hmm. Just a second, folks.
Just west of the clearing, she explained. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I picked it up, something started helping me.
Hello.
Argus followed her motion.
A reader. With you.
Either.
Here. Right now.
Okay.
Quill, what you found is very powerful and very dangerous,
he said with great concern.
If I could take this burden from you, I would. But this reader has chosen.
Oh.
Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Oh?
Quill pressed.
Wait, Argus, isn't that the original hero?
No, he snapped. They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone.
No, you don't.
It is for your own safety. And
come on.
Here in the clearing.
Andrew, his last hat.
Heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I can help.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
I promise, she said reluctantly. Wondering where her uncle was going so deep into the night.
Next. Aha. Fuck that, we're not waiting. We are not waiting. Right. Hello, what's that? That's not me. Wait. Is that another reader?
Hey, kid. Kid. Wake up.
Hello.
Hey, kid, over here. I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them.
Alright. Let's see here.
Hey! Starthing, wait!
In here still, or is it just for show? Be in there. Ooh, hello. Didn't even see that one. Oh. Go. Yes.
Never met a starving. In campfire stories, they often meddled in the lives of mortals.
Hmm?
And when they appeared,
mischief followed. Hello. Still don't know what it is that I'm collecting there, but that'd be something.
Passage through the eastern gate was strictly forbidden. But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her.
Hey. Yeah. Oh, there's a scroll here. Yeah. Still don't know what those are for, but yeah. There we go.
Cole demanded answers.
Wait.
Starting, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he? What do you know?
Where is this? Is there anything here? Guess not. Okay. Smack!
The trouble Bye. Your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of.
Okay. Or the other way. That's the other way. Silent giant. I'm not that silent, you know. Fine. Call me that. Ooh, got a portal. There we go.
This way, kid. Urge the starving. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Sure, let's go. Not like I get any control in that part. Don't put out me. Ooh, deers. So, a deer, a fee. That's a huge axe. I got a feeling this portal's bigger. Alright, works. Fine, let's go. Macadoodle. Ooh, breaking a certain amount of twigs or something. Is there anything down there, my heart? Can I swim? Oh. Well, bollocks, I can't swim. I did not know that. So y'all know. Dragonflies. Don't fall in. Dangerous. And I see a scroll. Ah. Don't know how many of those I need, though. I'm just smashing things, collecting something. Oh. There's a deer there. Oh, is there more? There we go. That's more like it. Up we go. Wait. Bollocks, that was not what I wanted to do. Oh, I see where I had to go. Do that again. I'm not leaving that scroll behind if I have an option. Okay, up. In here as well. At least it looks like it. There we go. Another scroll. Yeah. So, here, though, doesn't matter. I won't hurt you. No, nothing here. All right. And a helmet? Ooh, that's armor. This is an old battlefield. Okay, let's see how to get here. Can I do that? I'll go up here. Smash! Push. Smash. Smash. Push. Push. I see where I have to go. Up here? Oh, over there? Uh-huh. And then underneath the armor. Boy. Yeah.
Just on the other side is the mire. The starling assured her.
Okay.
There's a good chance your uncle's still there.
Yeah, there's the squirrel he rode on. Oh. Oh, you control that? Fair. A lot of swords there, though.
There you are.
Did you hear that? The starling seemed anxious. I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me.
Okay. Fine. Don't go and die on me. All the help I got from you, I guess. Go for the, That's gonna break. That's gonna... God damn it. I told you that was gonna break. Ooh, hello. Yeah, you're welcome. I don't know what that was about, but you're welcome. This is so pretty, though. So damn pretty. Yeah, there we go. That's better. Prickly's up here. All right. You're annoying, though. Smells up there? Let me see, I'm still in there. Yeah. Alright, I just noticed, I paused the game, and right up in the top corner, 8 scrolls, 39 glittery things. Don't know what they are. Oh, hello, look at that. Don't know what they are, but that's what I got, apparently. Seeing any scrolls up here either. Right. Not what I expected. There. Wrong way, apparently. There. There. Look at that. Nice. One of those things. Oh, hello. What's that? Oh boy. They're armored. Ow. Okay. There we go, much better quill. Like armored bugs, I guess. Oh boy, oh boy. Heal. There you go. Yeah. Nothing else around here, I guess. Nope. Alright. Up you go. Where's the arch?
A whisper echoed through the trees. Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
Do what now? That doesn't sound well. Good. Whatever. Yeah, there's more.
A fantastical band of sprites emerged surrounding Quill.
I'm Veda, root seer of the mire. And you have crossed into our domain.
Okay.
She sized up Quill with a rueful gaze and turned her attention upward.
Hi there.
Sense you there too. I have not felt the presence of such a promising reader in some time.
Good for me, I guess.
A youthful warrior marched forward. Rootseer! I'm prepared to honor our great champion's legacy. Rodent, give us our glass.
Oh. I'm staying with Quill.
Quill stepped closer. Where is my uncle? If you've hurt him...
Silence!
Veda thundered back.
It was Argus who summoned us here, and now I see why.
Mm-hmm.
Young one, I'm afraid the trees hum of attack. Your uncle's been taken to the castle of your ancestors.
Quill's knees buckled as Veda continued.
Argus put himself at great risk calling for us.
Mm-hmm. I've got to go rescue my uncle.
A solemn oath to protect the glass of your fallen king. He is the only one left who knows where it's been hidden. The Arcane have long sought to wrest that knowledge from him.
Right?
And you dare to cross into the mire with our glass? Sarfog will soon burn through this forest looking to tear you and your reader apart.
Yeah. Primey.
Unless you find them first. Take these. Weapons made for the mighty champion who died so that your people could live.
Weapons, weapons.
Felt its otherworldly power course through her. Find the your uncle to
brass blade.
Before the serpent and its masters break him.
The warrior fumed.
Our glass with her? Rootseer, she's minuscule.
Come now. The reader has chosen its hero.
Indeed.
We must let their story unfold.
Veda replied with a frost of finality and vanished into the shadows of the mire.
And whoosh, we go again. Right. Folks, I will be quitting right now. We will finish this chapter that we're loading into next time. Okay. Go. Save data. That's my save data, okay. 9 and 39, right. Equipment, I can check my equipment. Take that. Armor. Cool, alright, fine. But, folks, thank you for being here with me. We will continue the adventure of Mob next time. Bye.